I'm Cindy Margolis, and you're watching Bloody Popcorn Review. Love you, baby, with love and kisses and blood and fangs and whip and chains and sticks and stones, and I love you.
Boogeyman. Hello and welcome to a special edition of Bloody Popcorn TV. Now, instead of doing a normal review like I usually do, I'm going to do a top 10 favorite death scenes, and they just have to be my favorite 10 list. So it's like a top 10 of all time, just the ones that I like. So don't hear no complaining, like, hey, I don't agree with this, it's just my opinion, and feel free to throw your own opinions afterwards. Now for number 10, the very first one, I am going to show you one of my favorite scenes from the movie Hatchet. A scene I like to call Open Up and Say Ah. Now this scene is very, very different than your normal slasher movie, like as opposed to, like, say, Jason, who just stabs you. This killer in Hatchet, Victor Crowley, he likes to make you suffer. He wants you to know you're gonna die. He's not, there's no fun here, nothing quick and easy. You're gonna die, you're gonna suffer. Enjoy. The next kill in our countdown is from Resident Evil. Now, a lot of people don't really consider the Resident Evil series kind of horror, but I do. Got a lot of horror elements, so I'm going to include it. It's the scene where they're trying to get to the main computer box, and everything looks like it's going well. All of a sudden, one guy gets trapped, and then the security system comes on, and it's like, I don't want to tell you, if you haven't seen it, or you're not really sure, I'm not going to say too much, because you're going to see it right now in a minute. But I call this scene lasered, because this guy is he's lasered. That's basically what happened. He got lasered.
What's that?
Captain, quick! Get him out of there! What's happening in there? Captain, you gotta hurry! You gotta help them!
Down!
Oh my God, Captain, there's something killing them in there! Hurry, you gotta hurry!
Next on our list comes from the classic Day of the Dead. Now, what I like about this scene the most is, I remember seeing it the first time, besides being beyond brutal, I was like, how do you even do it? I mean, I was just freaked out. I mean, it just looks so brutal. It's the scene where the captain, I think it's Captain, he's a soldier, he's talking, he's been training zombies with a gun, and old irony comes to pay him back. And not only is it beyond gory, it's kind of hilarious. Enjoy!
Thank you.
Next on our list comes from the movie Saw 3. Now, in my opinion, of all the Saw movies, this one guy, he gets the worst. I don't know what Jigsaw didn't like about him or something. This guy gets the worst of all the traps. I like to call this scene Twist and Shout. Enjoy! Now that was a really brutal scene. Now, if any of you are watching, you're wondering why is that, you know, so high up. Again, just a reminder, this is just favorite scenes that I like. There's no real, that's not like the top 10 ever, just scenes that I like in particular. Just so we're on the same page here. Now for my next scene, one of my favorites from the movie Laid to Rest, another movie that's similar to Hatchet, where the deaths are very creative. Like, you don't see people getting killed like this in any other franchise. Very unique, and whoever wrote it always got issues. I like to call this scene Face Off. Enjoy!
I would never cheat on you, and I never have. Next
on our list is from the remake of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, so already you know it's going to be good. Now, in this original Texas Chainsaw Massacre and the remake with the theatrical version, this is actually edited a lot. So I would suggest you look it up on the internet, or if you have the DVD or Blu-ray, watch the unseen version, the unedited version, because it is way more brutal. And I feel sorry for this guy. Again, like in the whole movie, he gets it the worst. It's a scene I like to call Up Yours. Enjoy! Next on our list comes from the movie Wrong Turn 2. Now, what I like about this scene is this is the first death scene in the movie. It's like right in the beginning. So you know if this is the first scene, what else is going to happen? What else crazy is going to possibly happen? This scene is so like brutal and messed up. That's why I like it. So hopefully you like it too. It's a scene I like to call it the splits. Enjoy!
I'm here.
Next on our list is from one of the all-time classic films, Jaws. Now, I don't know if a lot of people don't consider it a horror movie. I do, because even though it's rated PG, it's really scary, and some of the stuff it's a little gory. Maybe it was okay back in the 80s or late 70s. It was probably acceptable. I don't think nowadays it would count as a rated R movie. But this one particular scene, it's where the main fisher guy, Quinn, he finally gets what's coming to him. And what makes this scene for me so great is like, it just, when you're watching, it just feels so real, because there's like no music playing as they have. You just see him slowly descending into what's going to be his death. And as the viewer, you kind of just feel it. It's like, oh, it's really unnerving. That's why I like it so much. I call this scene, Quinn, that's what's for dinner. Enjoy. Next on our list, and just if you're keeping count, it's number 2, so we're almost at the end, so yay, I hope you're excited, is from the movie Scream, and as by, you know, Wes Craven was involved, so, you know, you have a lot of high hopes for it, and I think since Wes Craven was doing this film, he probably knew, it's been a while, so I gotta make sure I show people, you know, who the fuck they're talking to. This is a Wes Craven movie. So this first death scene is just brutal, and I think of all the whole series, again, this is the first scene that's the most brutal, the most dramatic. I call this scene, Spill Your Guts. Enjoy!
Jesus.
What is it?
Get in the car. Drive down to the Mackenzies.
No, no, my daughter.
Let's go.
No, my daughter.
Call the police.
Wow, wasn't that crazy? I mean, they must not have liked her. I mean, she must have been a bitch, you know, in high school or something. They did not like her. And finally, we come to number 1. Now, even though this isn't a traditional top 10, it's just my favorite. I would have to say this is my favorite of all the death scenes that I've ever seen. It's from Nightmare on Elm Street, the original classic, not the shitty remake, the original Wes Craven masterpiece. Now, Nightmare on Elm Street was like the first horror movie I can remember seeing, and this scene is beyond just brutal. Like, I don't know what happened. Freddie hated Tina so much. I'm thinking when the whole parents lynched Freddie and they got him, Tina's mom, he must have poked him in the eye with a stick or something. He just wanted her to suffer. So welcome to my number one pick, my number one favorite death scene of all, Freddie Hates Tina. Enjoy! Well, that's my top 10 favorite all the time. You've been split, you've been cut, you've been torn into shreds, you've been eaten. If you think you have anything better, please mention it in the comments, because Bloody Popcorn works for you. Yes, I should check it out. Let me know, because Bloody Popcorn. Wow, I had it in my head. Oh, because Bloody Popcorn. Wait, Bloody Popcorn. I had it in my head. I just. Thanks a lot for the vodka, man.
Yeah.
You too. You gave him the money.
Sure.
And I paid for the rest of it, so it's my fault.
I would say, okay, stop it.
It's part.